Hello and welcome back to the fourth and last part of the video series about the N9's PostgreSQL. My name is Patrick Hartz and we talked in the last videos about several aspects in the lifetime of a data service instance besides the creation and deletion. Last time I explained how to take backups and I also talked about the different backup strategies which are provided by the N9's PostgreSQL service. As we have learned, the self-service capabilities of Cloud Foundry and the N9 Data Service Framework come along with a lot of benefits and simplifications regarding the creation and management of data service instances. We are able to take backups and we can tweak the data service instance up to our needs. As we are responsible for the data service ourselves, we need a good toolset to detect whether an instance behaves like it should. The first thing I will talk about is the possibility of receiving metrics from a service instance and show them in a Grafana dashboard. For this purpose, we can use the N9's Prometheus service. In a later video, we will talk in more detail about the N9's for Prometheus. For the time being, it is sufficient that we can stream metrics from our service instance to the Graphite exporter, which is part of the N9's for Prometheus service. Similar to the N9's PostgreSQL service, we can create a dedicated N9's for Prometheus service instance for this purpose. To save some time, I have already created one. Now we can continue from the point where we have to create a service key. If you want to know more about service keys, I recommend to check out the first video if you haven't already seen it. The reason why we need a service key is because of the credentials we got back contains the host of the Graphite exporter. We need this host to let the service instance know where to stream the metrics to. Let's check out the service instance I created. In the services overview, we will find the Prometheus service instance. That's the one I talked about. To create a service key, we can use the command cf create service key, the name of the service instance, and the name for the key. So let's get back the service key. And that's the URL I talked about. This is the URL of the Graphite exporter. We need this URL and as well the port. To let our Postgres service instance know where to stream the metrics to, we have to update the service instance. We did a similar thing when we adjusted the service instance. CF update service. The name of the service instance, it's mypg minus c for the custom parameter. The property we have to set is called Graphite. It expects an array. This should be okay. Let's wait a moment until the configuration was applied to the service instance.
A few moments later.
We can use the time to already open the Grafana dashboard. To retrieve the Grafana dashboard, we can check out the details of the service instance. Copy the URL, open your browser and paste in the URL. One hint, at the time this video is recorded, the N9's for Prometheus is still in beta and we have to add Grafana to the URL. When the N9's for Prometheus is out of beta, we will have a similar dashboard like we have for the N9's PostgreSQL. It will contain in the header some links where we can reach several dashboards, like the Grafana dashboard, also one for the Prometheus itself, and Alert Manager. So, now let's check how far the update of our service instance is. Let's see if service mypg. The update is succeeded. So this means we should see first metrics in our dashboard. In the Grafana dashboard, we already have some pre-configured dashboards. One for Elasticsearch, MongoDB, MySQL, and also one for the PostgreSQL. In the dashboard for the PostgreSQL related metrics, we can see a lot of metrics like deadlocks, nodes, database size, also the size of the while directory. In the video about the NE9s for Prometheus, we will talk in more detail how to create new graphs and show them in the dashboard. So there is also a dashboard available where you can see simple system metrics. This is the same then for all kind of data services, which comes with the data service framework. It contains information about the disk space, the used memory, and so on. In the video for the NE9s for Prometheus service, we will also show how you can set up alerts to get informed when a metric is outside a predefined boundary. Not only the metrics are important when we search for the reason why a service instance is no longer responding. Next, we will configure a syslog endpoint to the service instance to let the instance stream syslogs to a syslog server. A service we can use for this is the NE9s LogMe. Shortly explained, it is a combination of Elasticsearch, LogMe, and Kibana, a so-called egg stack. The creation of such an instance takes some time, so I already created one. Again, we need a service key which contains the host of the syslog endpoint. Let's cfcreate service key, LogMe, and the name for the key, we take my key. So let's get back the service key. And this is what we need. Again, we have to update our service instance. The property we have to update now is called syslog. Like you already know, this will take some time, and in the meantime, we will open the dashboard for our LogMe instance. So with cf service LogMe, we will get back the dashboard URL, copy it, paste it into your browser and jump to the Kibana dashboard. Before we can see first metrics, we have to wait until the update is succeeded.
2 very boring minutes later.
Okay, let's see how far the update is. So the update is succeeded. And now we should see some metrics. Let's cover. The metrics we can see here are from the several nodes of the Postgres instance and also from the NE9s parachute. I never talked about the NE9s parachute so far. The NE9s parachute is a mechanism which observes the disk usage of a virtual machine and stops the processes when a certain threshold is reached. This prevents the database from unexpected behavior when there's no space left on ephemeral or persistent disk again. If this happens, you should increase the instance to a larger plan. You could also adjust the threshold. In the documentation, you can find instructions on how to do that. But I would highly recommend to update your instance because adjusting the threshold is just a short-term solution. Now we should have a look on the service dashboard of our Postgres instance. Copy the URL, open again our browser. I already explained in the last video that the dashboard is split into several sections. There's also one section where you can get a basic overview about the usage of your memory, disk, and the CPU. Have you ever tried turning it off and on again?
Hello, IT. Have you tried turning it off and on again?
With all the information we can collect, you should have a good understanding what is going on with our service instance. Sometimes we have to adjust a parameter, but it can also happen that we have to restart or recreate our service instance. You can also do this in the dashboard. There's a section where you can restart or recreate your service instance. The difference between the recreate and the restart is, in the case of a restart, the automation is just shutting down the processes on the virtual machine and it's starting them again. In the case of a recreate, the processes will be shut down, then the automation is taking the virtual machine offline, a new virtual machine is created and attached to the persistent disk again. Here two remarks. In case of a cluster, you can do this with nearly a zero downtime because each node gets updated, or better, recreated one by one. And the second is, we already learned that the underlying automation, Bosch, is separating the virtual machine from its persistent data. This means when the virtual machine is recreated, the persistent disk is attached again and there's no loss of data. Self-service comes along with a lot of responsibilities. Instead of calling a hotline, we have to take care of the service instance ourselves. In this video, we showed possible ways to observe our service instance. I hope you enjoyed the video series about the Anylines PostgreSQL service. We will create new videos about other services provided by the Anylines Data Service Framework. Thanks for watching this video. I hope to see you next time. If you like our content, leave a like, push the subscribe button and follow us on YouTube and our other social media channels.